The base station will have 5 layers with support rings against pressure. The outer layer will be made of a superalloy to prevent corrosion, oxidation, and thermal creeping. An acrylic layer will then block alpha and beta radiation, while a further layer of water will block neutron radiation, resulting in the emission of gamma rays, which will be blocked by a layer of lead. Electrical circuits will form the inner layer, connecting components to energy sources. Geothermal energy is the main source, since ocean thermal energy conversion uses heat stored in the ocean to constantly generate electricity. Europa's oceans are thought to be heated due to elliptical orbits that produce internal friction. Using the ocean's natural temperature gradient in an open cycle system, water boils in a low pressure container, producing steam to drive a turbine coupled to a generator. Solar powered satellites will be deployed to convert solar energy into microwave energy and beam it onto a retinal on Europa's surface, converting the EM waves into DC electricity. This is efficient in space since sunlight is not filtered by the atmosphere, reducing energy loss, but output may fluctuate. The satellites will also allow the use of high-speed lasers for constant communication with Earth.
To protect from Jupiter's radiation belt, crew members will wear lead suits which prevent ionization. Exercising in the gym is necessary for the crew to prevent irreversible internal damage. Pedaling on a cycle ergometer will measure fitness by checking the heart rate. Jogging whilst harnessed to a treadmill will keep bones and muscles healthy. Weightlifting on the resistance exercise device will provide a full body workout by stretching muscles. Machines will be linked to convert kinetic energy into electrical energy to power less demanding machinery. Food will consist of single service disposable containers with flexible packaging to aid trash compression. High yield and protein food will be cultivated in a computer controlled greenhouse. Temperature and humidity will be adjusted using automatic systems paired with sensors. CFL bulbs will provide light energy. A water filtration system will create drinkable water by passing waste products through a high-pressure filter to remove organic and inorganic waste. The water will then be disinfected and purified in a valve and resin system. An oxygen recycling system will extract water from the air through condensation and electrolysis.
This submersible is based off a Greenland shark and is hence streamlined and cylindrical to resist high pressures. An umbilical cable and tether system allow communication with the base and energy access. A lithium-ion battery is a backup source to ensure constant control in case the tether breaks. 12 LED lamps, a 3D stereoscope, and infrared cameras will provide a 360-degree view. Ice corers will collect samples of the ice sheet. This untethered deep-sea submersible is spherically shaped with 6 manipulated legs, inspired by deep-sea crab. The legs anchor onto the ocean bed and transfer samples to the pressurized storage area. Energy will be provided by the lithium-ion batteries attached to an electrical generator coupled to hydraulic propellers. This system will use radio waves for communication, along with full-spectrum ship tech. The pilots see a virtual image of the immediate surroundings and SIT underwater lowlight, LED, and infrared cameras to show the actual surroundings. They are made of titanium to cope with high heat and pressure and to resist corrosion from the acidic ocean, whilst being more efficient due to low density. A sonar system, including a side scan, sub-bottom frequency, and bathymetric capabilities, will be used with an ultra-short baseline tracking system with acoustic communication to calculate the relative position to a transceiver. Horizontal drive will be controlled by 2 hydraulic pump propellers and vertical drive by a ballast tank and pressurized air flask.
The spacecraft will be assembled in a clean room with airflow systems to filter out contaminants. Hardware will be sterilized by dry heating microbial reduction. Limulus amoebocyte lysate assay is fast sensitive and will be used to detect live and dead organisms by sensing microbial cell wall materials. Potential extremophiles would have to survive severe temperatures, pressures, radiation, and salinity levels and the vacuum in space. Large organisms rarely survive this. However, terrestrial bugs and the specific Natrialba magardii and Deinococcus radiodurans bacteria have endured simulated conditions similar to Europa. Europa's ice sheet is cracked into plate-like forms, hence organisms may be similar to Earth's own but with further adaptations such as being able to see in the dark since Europa has less sunlight. Samples will be analyzed by examining tissues, proteins, and behavior with microscopes. Videos will be recorded and sent to Earth. There is a high risk of contaminating samples with our own organic material, hence trackers should be used with little direct contact in the quarantined lab. Samples will be sustained in different watertight cabinets. The conditions would reflect the environment the samples were taken from, including temperature, pressure, salinity, and acidity. They would be monitored twice daily to check conditions and replace minerals, nutrients, and water.